My name is Jeppe Tengbjerg. I am the founder of the International Massage Association, and I'm the CEO of the World Championship in Massage and other tournaments. For many years, chair massage was underestimated, but it will never happen again. Chair massage won gold in 2019 in the overall category and silver in 2018 at the World Championship in massage in Denmark. A massage chair is a chair designed for massages. Traditional massage chairs allow easy access to the head, shoulders and back of a massage receiver. This class is for those who are planning to give massage treatments in another way and for those who already give chair massage but want to learn more. This class is, however, a chair massage class where we learn to give classical Swedish massage on the skin, where we use the classical massage grips, effleurage, petrissage, tapotement, vibration and friction with cream and oil. Let us begin with our Swedish chair massage. We begin with effleurage of the upper back and the lower back. We do our palpation, the heating, and we are lubricating the massage cream and massage oil. Then we do the hand palm friction of erector spina. It is the erector spina on the upper side of the spine I am making a pressure on. I do a little circle around the spine. And then I do another friction of erector spina, but it's on the same side in which I'm standing. And I take erector spina. I'm also doing the latissimus dorsi and triceps muscle. And I even touch levator scapula. Then I use my knuckles on the upper triceps muscle. Could also be levator scapula. I can use my knuckles or my palm. And now do the same procedure on the other side before proceeding. Let's continue. We're doing a petrissage of upper triceps muscles. And the next thing will be the circulation massage. And we begin on levator scapula. We make circulations in order to find the tension. And maybe we end up making a pressure. We can do it again. Finding the tension, make a pressure. And circulation massage we can do on several muscles. I continue on upper triceps. I can continue on rhomboid muscles. Again, I can do it several times. I search for the tension, smaller circles, and give a pressure. This I can also do on infraspinatus. Finding the tension, maybe it's a trigger point, maybe it's just a tension. And I can do so on teres major and teres minor, doing the same circulation massage, smaller circles, finding pressure. Do it again. Ending up doing the triceps origin with a knuckle friction like this. It can be very painful, so in order to adapt, you can use your palm instead. But still, it can be very painful. Now we do a pectorage of the neck. We can use both hands in this situation. If the client has longer hair, you keep the hair away and only use one hand. Then we go in front of the chair and we make a palm pressure on the levator scapula. Other scapula. We can make a finger pressure on the skull of the neck. We can do it several places. And then we'll do a knuckle friction of the muscles of the neck, but also upper triceps muscle. And the next thing we will do is a circulation massage of supraspinatus, looking like this. Big circle, minor circle, finding the tension and make a pressure. Again, big circle and a pressure. Do the same on the other side. The next thing we do is continuing on behind the clients on the rhomboid muscles on the left side of the spine between columna and scapula. The next thing I will do is a palm friction of erector spina away from the spine, trying to use my body weight. Then I will use my thumb, and I actually use a double thumb. Between the spine and erector spina, I pressure erector spina away from the spine. The next thing I do is butterfly pressure on erector spina. We do it symmetrical. I do it twice. We use our body weight. And I do it rhythmical. Looks like this. One hand, second hand, first hand, second hand, etc. We do it again. Following techniques are for the lower back. We begin with petrissage of quadratus lumborum. We can also use both hands. Then we can make circulation massage on the opposite side of quadratus lumborum, big circles, smaller circles, and the pressure when we find the tension. Do it again. Yeah. On the quadratus lumborum nearest yourself, you can begin with a hand palm and make a pressure towards the spine. first with the palm, two times, and then you can use your double thumb. It is more sharp. And before going any further, you take the opposite side with the same massage grip. We continue with the arm, the lower arm actually, starting here between the thumb and the second finger, making a pressure. And the next thing is we will take, especially brachioradialis sitting here, we do it with our palm, but we will do it while stretching a little bit. So it looks like this. You can use your palm and you can use your finger and you can use your forearm. It can also be this arm. Then we make a massage across the fibers. It looks like this. And we can make circulations. You can do it with your palm, and you can of course do it as well with your thumb. Now we stretch the top of the hand with our palms, and we make massage of each finger, inside, outside, front side, back side, looks like this. And just also pull a little bit in each joint while doing so. And then you turn the arm. Then we continue on the other side of the lower arm. We still make palm pressure on the lower arm, on on the flexor muscles. And while doing this, stretching a little bit, I can use my palm, but I can also use my thumb while doing so. The thumb is always sharper. And you can do it with your forearm. And we can give massage across the fibers. And we can make circulation massage. Then we come to the hand. We give massage, especially inside here, on the adductor muscle of the thumb, but also on the tendon to the fingers. Then we make a stretch, like this. And we make thumb pressure at the same time. And we can do so while pressuring also on the tendons. And then we can take the ligament here in the hand joint where the carpal tunnel is. Now do the other arm before proceeding. Now I will show some extra massage techniques. We can begin with giving massage to the connective tissue. We do it like this. Take the tissue. We can do it several times and from different angle. We use it not only for treatment, but also for examinations of the body. So you can actually begin while doing this. The next technique is the banana squeeze. can be used for triceps, Achilles, and other places. The next technique, I use my forearm, standing in front of the chair, make forearm rolls. And with this technique, we can make a pressure with our forearm on their upper triceps, levator, scapula, and of course supraspinatus as well. And we can of course do it over here. The next technique is a pitch exercise of deltoid muscle, doing like this. Again, of course, we can use two hands. But we can also use only one. The next technique is kind of a stretch. We take the arm down, we take the shoulder, and we ground the head and we pull the shoulder, so there will come a nice stretch. You can do it twice. But it's the pulling part that is important. The next technique is a finger pressure on the upper triceps and levator scapula and supraspinatus. The next massage technique, we use our knee in the hand to stabilize, and then we take the shoulder a little bit up and we use our thumb and we give massage beneath the shoulder blade, the scapula, on rhomboid muscles. Now we give massage on the trigger point on infraspinatus. Make a pressure. Keep the pressure for several seconds. The next massage grip is more mobilization of the shoulder joint. But while doing so, you can actually also make a pressure on the triceps muscle. When the arm goes up, you can go deep. The next grip is actually a stretch. We take the arm, we place our knee in his arm, we take the shoulder and the scapula, the shoulder blade, and we make a stretch of rhomboid muscle. We can do so while actually giving massage. make a stretch and a massage of the rhomboid muscles. The next massage techniques are in upright sitting position. We take our fingers and we make a movement of the head in this direction. And while doing so, we use our thumb at upper tripeps. We do like this, pressure, back again, pressure, back again. Rotate again and make a pressure. Let's do it again. Point one. Point two, point three, and you can use your underarm, point one, point two, point three, and you can use your elbow, point one, point two, point three. And the next massage technique is the cobra stretch. Take the arm, ask them to hold tight. Take the other arm, ask them to hold tight. We make a little stretch. We do it twice. Now we give some head muscle massage. We used our four fingers on the masseter muscle. And the four fingers we can also use on temporalis. We can also use our palm on temporalis. And we can use our palm on frontalis like this. The next massage grip is a grip with the elbow, and we raise the arm in order to make a tricep stretch. But when we do the stretch, my right elbow is making a pressure on triceps, on levator scapula, maybe even rhomboid muscle. We stretch triceps, and we make a pressure on tripeps, on levator, and the rhomboid. The next massage grip is a stretch of the pectoralis major muscle. We do it like this, take the arms, doing like this, and we make a stretch like this. Do it twice. The next massage grip is a grip for thorax. We take the arm back and we lift up the body. So, we do it again, we go back, and we lift. Make a nice stretch on thorax, on the side of the body. The next technique is the butterfly rotation. Oh. We go in here, we make a rotation, make a stretch, take the right elbow to the left hip. And we do the same on the other side. If you won't do or can't do the butterfly spinal twist, you can do a half butterfly. Do it like this. And you make a stretch and a rotation. You make a pressure on the right scapula and make the stretch of the left pectoralis major. Now we make a stretch for the side of the body. We take the hand to the ear. We take the other hand and we hold tight. And we ground here and we make the stretch here. We make it twice. Do it on the other side, to the ear, yeah. We ground here, and we stretch here. Do it twice. I hope you found this video useful and inspiring and can use these many massage grips in your daily work. I hope that you will give Swedish massage on chair. Not many do so, but it will come, it will be part of the future.